Simulation of Engineering in Nigeria, CORIN, is the statutory body set up by the federal government of Nigeria with the mandate to regulate the practices of engineering in all aspects and ramifications. It was established by the Decree 55 of 1970s and amended by Decree 27 of 1992. The engineering professional body is driven by the wish to protect people and society at large from the danger associated with engineering failure. CORIN was therefore inaugurated to ensure the highest standards of professionalism in engineering practices in Nigeria and the elimination of quirks. The council avoid unnecessary competition among practitioners and prevent them from taking advantage of the people in illegal ways or through unfair deals. The president of the Council for the Regulation of Engineering in Nigeria, Sadiq Abubakar, he asked the federal government to exit the council from the non-funding policy of professionals and regulatory bodies in the country, scheduled to begin in January 2024. He stated this at the 31st Engineering Assembly team, Enhancing and Strengthening Engineering Practitioners Code of Conduct for Resident Engineering Practices in Nigeria, held in Abuja on Tuesday, 2023. In an exclusive interview with famous news channels and Safety View Television, participants highlight the experience.
My name is Matthew Ferrin, I'm a practicing engineer. Yeah, I think the 31st Assembly of the CORIN Council for the Regulation of Engineering in Nigeria, it has been a huge success based on my own assessment. The lectures that have been delivered, the codes and standards, trying to strengthen what we do, applying the codes and standards. I think it has been a rewarding moment, honestly, I have to say. And I can say CORIN has done a very good job. Looking at the last assemblies I have attended, I think they have actually left a day in the sound of time.
Thank you, sir. Now, looking at you as an engineer, sir, what could be your core message in respect to the building collapse in Nigeria?
Yeah, I think a building collapse has become almost like a thing that happens every now and then, which is actually not good for us as a country and as a regulatory body, CORIN. Yes, I think to curb a building collapse in Nigeria and other parts of the world, I want to say that engineers, you know, sometimes we just pass the ball for the blame that maybe quacks have done the job. I think that may not just be completely right. We engineers should also take responsibility. Taking responsibility, I mean, if you practice, for instance, as a civil engineer, practice within your core area. If you're an architect, practice within your core area. Unless you have been trained, certified, maybe to train in other, to practice in other areas. If not, stay within your core engineering practice so that mistakes are not made. A situation where maybe, for instance, you have a builder doing, for instance, the work of a civil engineer or doing the work of a mechanical engineer, maybe based on the experience they have on site, that sometimes really doesn't work. Stay within what you have trained to do. Apply the codes, apply the standards. With that, I think the incident building collapse we have seen all over the country, we can reduce it, possibly eliminate it completely. Thank you. Okay, I'm the managing director of Password Engineering Limited. We are an EPCM company, engineering procurement and construction management. And anyone that wants to contact us, I think can reach us on our phone number. 0809-809-6003. Our email address is info@passwordengineering.com. Our website is www.passwordengineering.com. We render services to the oil and gas and other sectors in the economy. We have done that.
Your office address,
sir? Our office is 14 Adeni Jones Avenue in Ikeja, Lagos. We have office there and we also have a contract in the United States, Houston, Texas.
Thank you very much.
I appreciate you.